Please rise for the presentation of colors as the flags of the United States of America and the state of California are brought in by the Honor Guard from the Richard A. McGee Correctional Training Center. Please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem by Captain Nathan Justin of California State Prison, Solano.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Please be seated. And now, Deacon Bill Gakey, CDCR chaplain from California State Prison, Sacramento, will lead the invocation.
Please join me with hearts and heads bowed before the Almighty, for whom we invoke this blessing. As the compassionate mercy of our Creator, God, dawns from on high upon us, let us share a new light that shines on us, in our work, and with us in our midst today. In honoring those gathered here who courageously approached others stricken into darkness or challenged by the shadows of death, we ask to be likewise strengthened in our walk, renewed with light and with truth by the Spirit guiding us. And not unlike the resolve of the biblical Good Samaritan, esteemed so long ago in a parable of Jesus, yet now is reflected in the actions of those exemplified here presently to be the best instruments today of mercy-filled peace. And so, as we recall that blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, so too may our Creator bless us in coming together to celebrate the great measures of protection that today's honorees have shared bravely. Through deeds accomplished so thoroughly, by coming into lives needing care so urgently, they have challenged the span of human events, especially in times of upheaval. In doing so, may this grace allow our communities to be more at peace and all the more thankful for the everlasting gifts of compassion and mercy in this life and for the next. Amen.
It is my privilege to introduce the Secretary of the California Department of Corrections and Rehabilitation, Scott Curran.
I don't know if you could tell, but I'm beaming with pride up here as the Secretary, looking out at our troops, 60,000 employees, 29,000 sworn, and we're here today to recognize the heroic events both in the prison and off duty. It is truly one of the honored events of our department. And I think it is because we get the opportunity to bring families in and get to meet with the families and recognize their loved ones' achievements. I'd also like to thank the California Correctional Supervisors Association. This is the 12th year that they've honored us with sponsoring this event, and it is greatly appreciated by the department and all CDCR employees. I'd also like to thank Creekside Christian Church for hosting us today in this great event. As you might know, Jerry Brown is now the longest serving governor in California history, and his experience of state government and policy is unrivaled. As secretary, I can personally attest to Governor Brown's leadership, including his great knowledge of correctional issues and his passion for reform. Please join me in giving a warm welcome and thanks to Jerry Brown.
Thank you, and I'll just say a few words in honor of those whom you recognize today. And the honor really is not just because of these individuals, but this whole spirit of courage and valor that is being recognized. We live in a society that in many ways is very prosperous, very powerful, has an unlimited number of gadgets and conveniences and opportunities, a very powerful market system. But at the end of the day, the strength of a society is not just its money or even its elections, much less its elected officials. It's the people themselves and their character and their virtue and how they treat themselves and their family and their neighbors. And those whom you honor today are strengthening our state and our country by what they've done. They've gone beyond the call of duty. They've acted in a way that is profoundly human and gives edification and inspiration to to everyone else who hears about it or sees it. And today, as we face so much cynicism with our leadership class, it's very important that from the bottom up, the strength of America and California be on display and be demonstrated. The prison system is a very unusual and unique institution. Most people have no idea what goes on. Things occur far from the knowledge and imagination of the ordinary citizens who pay for all this. You know, you're there. That's a tough job. There's violence, there's danger, there's dreariness, there's monotony, there's anxiety. And that takes its toll on the lives of people who work in our correctional system. So therefore, those who can demonstrate devotion to duty and going beyond and showing real valor, it's so important for the prison system, very important for the society itself. Because we are in an age of cynicism, we're in an age of great skepticism about how things work. And so when we see individuals inspiring us, edifying us by their behavior, then that builds the strength and the bonds of our community. We're seeing many changes in the correctional system. This is the only correctional system that the United States Supreme Court singled out in its decision a few years ago. And because of that decision, profound changes have been taking place. And because I was, you said I was the longest standing governor, I've been around more than most of you. I see a few gray hairs there. Maybe you've been around longer than me, but not most people know. I was around when Richard McGee was the Secretary of Corrections. That's the name on your event here, but on the building. So, but I've been around, I've seen it. I've seen the indeterminate sentence, I've seen the determinate sentence, I've seen the violence, I've seen the lawsuits, I've seen the crowding, I've seen the tremendous growth. And that's why as I reflect on this institution, I realize how important it is and how important we get things right. And getting things right is not just more laws. Getting things right depends how we treat each other in the system, how all of you perform your duties, and how the whole thing works together. And we're in the business now, not just of punishment, but of rehabilitation. Now, since I'm the guy who took the word rehabilitation out of the law, I don't know if you know all that. Yeah, I did that, 1977, SB 42. So I've had a chance to reflect on that. I'm very glad that my predecessor put rehabilitation back into the title of this organization. Very important. And whether we can rehabilitate to the greatest extent depends on the inmate themselves, but it also depends on others who can help that inmate. And those who work in the prisons, by their attitude, by their example, by their wisdom, can help in that rehabilitative process. So there's so many lives that are affected, all your lives, and your families, and your children, your relatives, and that's true also of the inmates. We're talking hundreds and hundreds of thousands of people. And this is such an intense system. There's nothing quite like it because of what gets people into prison, in many cases horrible crimes, and then so many of them are coming out, and how can we affect all that? Can there be change? Can we transform? And I was listening to the invocation about the Good Samaritan, and made me think of the Sermon on the Mount, where Jesus mentions visiting those in prison explicitly. One of the pillars of the entire basis of Christian civilization and Western society today. So that's a big responsibility, but it emphasizes how important the work that you're doing. And I appreciate it. I hope I appreciate it enough. And this year we're spending $100 million more in programs. We want to keep increasing that. We don't want to be naive, but we don't want to be cynical. We want to be virtuous, we want to be courageous, we want to get the job done for yourselves and for the people of California. Really important. I want to just add my congratulations and respect for the people who are being honored today and the great work that all of you do. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Governor. We are also joined today by honored guests from the state legislature. Please join me in welcoming Assemblyman Jim Cooper, who is here today. We thank you, Jim, for coming. Our first awards are for the Employee Recognition Program. Each year, directors in our divisions recognize employees in their areas for outstanding work. Presenting our Employee Recognition Awards is Kenneth Pogue, Undersecretary of Administration and Offender Services.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Sam. I've done a little bit of public speaking in my time, and generally I don't get nervous, but this is an event that I always walk up with butterflies, so you might have to bear with me because of the importance of these awards and the amazing work that this department does and that our employees do. And so it's really an honor to be up here, to be able to present these awards, and it's really important to me. So thank you all for being here today, and I'll try not to mess up any names. So the first award is for Administrator of the Year. Jason Lopez, Deputy Director of Fiscal Services, please come forward to accept your award. Mr. Lopez is highly regarded and respected by the Governor's Office, the Department of Finance, CDCR's Executive Office in the divisions, and I'm pretty sure his family as well. During the past year, Mr. Lopez has implemented changes that has resulted in keeping CDCR's budget well-balanced. And that's a big deal. We haven't had a deficiency in a number of years, and that's directly attributable to the amazing work that Jason and his team have done. He's eliminated overspending by placing more accountability on the programs and communicating proactively to head off problems. His commitment to ensuring that upper management is apprised of CDCR's fiscal health is constantly reiterated in meetings with the secretary and directors throughout CDCR. We appreciate you and congratulate you, Jason Lopez. Our next award is for Healthcare Services Professional of the Year. I need an S on the end, the Professionals of the Year for this one. This year, we are recognizing a team of 16 who successfully combated an outbreak of the Legionnaires' disease at San Quentin State Prison. They are also being honored with unit citations. The honorees are as follows. Dr. Fernand Alvarez, Dr. Denise Reyes, Dr. George Beatty, Dr. Clarine David, Dr. Shannon Garrigan, Dr. John Grant, Dr. Doreen Layton, Dr. Jenny Espinoza, Dr. Allison Paczynski, Dr. Michael Rowe, Dr. Daniel Smith, Dr. Raul Vanjani, and Dr. Lisa Pratt. Chief Medical Executive Alina Tootle, and Nurse Practitioners Ingrid Nelson and Peggy Hanna. As you can imagine, having this many doctors here today would severely constrain our ability to treat patients, so we are going to have Drs. Garrigan and Paczynski here to accept the award today. Please come forward and receive the award. In September 2015, San Quentin experienced an outbreak of Legionnaires' disease. It could have been deadly to the 5,400 inmates and staff if not for the actions of these primary care providers. Less than 2 hours after noticing a marked increase in pneumonia cases among patients, these staff exchanged their clinical suspicions, immediately researched possible causes, and established a working diagnosis and set parameters for treatment. As they began aggressively treating patients with antibiotics to halt exposure, these clinical staff members contained the outbreak and saved the lives of inmates and staff. Thank you all for your actions. Our next award is the Division of Juvenile Justice Professional of the Year. Dr. Heather Bowles, Associate Director of Mental Health, please come forward to receive your award. Dr. Bowles oversaw the development and implementation of DJJ's nationally recognized sexual behavior program. Treatment program. A court-appointed expert awarded the program 100% compliance rating. And if you know anything about court-appointed experts, I hope none of them are in the room, but they're very cynical individuals. So 100% is a really big deal for the department. Dr. Bowles was presented with the Christine M. West Award by the Forensic Mental Health Association of California. The award was in recognition of significant contributions she made to the field of forensic mental health. Because of her expertise, Dr. Bowles provided training on brain development to members of the Youthful Offender Program, the Board of Parole Hearings, and the numerous judges, public defenders, and district attorneys involved. Under her leadership, DJJ was successful in overhauling its mental health program. Dr. Bowles, congratulations on your outstanding record. Our next award is the Division of Rehabilitative Programs Professional of the Year. Jacqueline Jackie Lawden is the Divisional Rehabilitative Programs Professional this year. She is a Correctional Counselor 3. Please come forward to receive your award. Right. Correctional Counselor Lauderman has been instrumental in the successful progress of the Male Community Reentry Program in Los Angeles. She helped DRP activate and implement the reentry program while sustaining a collaborative relationship with stakeholders. Counselor Lauderman feels strongly about the rehabilitation effort at CDCR and believes it has an extremely positive impact on society. She is always looking for innovative ways to improve programming by making the best use of all available resources. Counselor Lauderman, congratulations on a job well done. Our next award is Division of Parole Operations Professional of the Year. Denise Milano, Regional Parole Administrator for the DAPO Northern Region, please come forward to receive your award. Under Administrator Milano's leadership, DAPO has successfully developed supervision models for a diverse and increasingly high-risk parolee population. Ms. Milano was closely involved in the development of the supervision plans for LIFR parolees, Prop 47 offenders, high-risk gang offenders, and DAPO's sex offender population. She was instrumental in developing DAPO's electronic monitoring program, which is recognized as a model for the effective use of electronic monitoring of high-risk offenders. Ms. Milano's expertise in budget management and personnel services spearheaded DAPO's efforts to reinstitute the Parole Agent Academy after several years of staff reductions. Her efforts on the National Institute of Justice Special Technical Committee have helped to define performance standards for the offender tracking system equipment and software nationwide. Administrator Milano, congratulations on your outstanding service. Next award is for Correctional Officer of the Year. Correctional Officer John C. Velasquez of the California Institute for Men, please come forward to receive your award. Officer Velasquez is an outstanding example of how to balance security duties with the need to encourage inmates to take advantage of rehabilitation opportunities. He is responsible for the safety and security of approximately 540 inmate students and about 25 contract and division of rehabilitative program staff. Many inmates have commented that Officer Velasquez is a no-nonsense type who treats them in a fair and consistent manner. Managerial staff have personally witnessed Officer Velasquez counsel inmates on many occasions about the importance of programming positively. He has the ability to promote the department's rehabilitative goals and, if necessary, immediately go to corrections mode. Congratulations, Officer Velasquez. The next award is for Correctional Supervisor of the Year. Lieutenant Andres Benuelos of the California Institute for Men, please come forward to receive your award. Lt. Lieutenant Benuelos supervises a facility that covers all second watch staff of approximately 40 positions, a dining hall, education and substance abuse reentry programs. The facility has a population of more than 1,000. Lieutenant Benuelos has been instrumental in making a positive change for inmates and staff. His emphasis on quality communications has been felt facility-wide. His leadership and communication skills have significantly reduced complaints from inmates and disciplinary actions against inmates. After a recent inspection by the American Correctional Association, the auditors specifically mentioned Lieutenant Benuelos' faculty and positive relationship among staff and inmates. Congratulations. Our final employee recognition award is for the Executive of the Year. Warden Clark Dukart of Pelican Bay State Prison, please come forward and receive your award. Warden Dukart has compiled a distinguished career of more than 30 years at Pelican Bay. He successfully handled tough assignments including the ACA reaccreditation of Pelican Bay, meeting the criteria set forth in the Plata lawsuit, which led to the delegation of healthcare authority at Pelican Bay back to the state, reviewing over 900 security housing unit inmates for release to the general population since October 2015 due to the Asker lawsuit settlement agreement, activating the only restricted custody general population housing unit in CDCR. Warden Dukart provides leadership by delegating and exercising appropriate oversight and supporting his management team. Congratulations. Our next awards are for Distinguished Service Medals. The Distinguished Service Medal is awarded for an employee's work conduct within the department for a period of months or years, or involvement in a specific assignment of unusual benefit to the department. Our first Distinguished Service Medal is awarded to Charles Wood, Correctional Health Services Administrator 2 at California State Prison, Sacramento. Please come forward. Mr. Woods led the development and implementation of several highly successful mass casualty incident training, drills, and full-scale exercises. Since launching the program, the prison has successfully responded to two large incidents. Medical staff noted the response to these incidents unfolded just like the staff learned in exercises. Mr. Woods' training and exercise program has been recognized by CDCR leadership, and this program may soon become the model for other institutions. Congratulations, Mr. Wood. Our next Distinguished Service Medal is awarded to David Johns, Parole Agent 2. Please come forward to accept your award. In September of 2015, Lake County suffered one of the worst wildfires in California history. Agent Johns responded to a call for all law enforcement agencies to assist. He conducted safety checks and helped escort evacuees from the area. He repeatedly entered the fire area to help people leave safely. Agent Johns worked an entire weekend helping people secure clothing, food, and other essential items. Agent Johns relocated parole services to a city outside the fire area so parolees could continue to receive help. He persuaded displaced parolees to continue their treatment and efforts towards rehabilitation. Congratulations, Agent Johns. Also receiving Distinguished Service Medals are now awarded to a team of 5 parole agents. As I call your name, please come forward and receive your award. Parole Agent 1, Richard Gonzalez. Michelle Cachalaguita. Did I get it right? All right. Kenneth Thomas. Eduardo Sanchez. And Parole Agent 2, Joshua Bateson. In reviewing officer-involved shooting incidents, this team of agents noted a deficiency in agents' ability to respond to medical needs. These agents took it upon themselves to create a combat lifesaver curriculum. In July 2013, they conducted their first week-long course with other parole agents and have now trained more than 100 law enforcement officers. Since the first course, trained parole agents have been credited with saving 5 lives in officer-involved shooting incidents. Congratulations to all of you. Our next Distinguished Service Medal is awarded to three Division of Parole Operations employees. The honorees are Parole Services Associate Cecilia Gutierrez and Elizabeth Ornelas, and Parole Agent 3 Patricia Tejas. Mr. Ornelas cannot be here today, so Ms. Gutierrez and Ms. Tejas, please accept the reward for your co-employee. Responding to a need to reduce the number of outstanding parolees at large warrants, this team developed intelligence about the whereabouts of such parolees in 45 states and 11 countries. The team was able to close more than 700 cases since 2010 and save the state more than $1.25 million from open warrants. The team's work provided safety and closure to numerous victims, prevented immeasurable further crime, and gave hundreds of parolees an opportunity to get their lives back on track and put their warrants in the past. Congratulations to all of you. Our next Distinguished Service Medal is Correctional Officer Don Hirschberger of the California Correctional Center. Please come forward. While off duty, Officer Hirschberger plays a central role in the delivery of humanitarian services to children in need throughout California and the United States by working to combat the horrors of child sex trafficking. Officer Hirschberger spoke at the state capitol for the Not in My City, Not in My State campaign and played a key role in the organization of a triathlon in 2015 to support the fight against child sex trafficking. The event generated almost $13,000 in donations, and she is working to make the triathlon an annual event. Congratulations. Our next Distinguished Service Medal is awarded to Captain Marlena Dernicourt of California State Prison Solano. Captain Dernicourt devotes a great deal of her off-duty time to the Special Olympics, the world's largest sports organization for people with intellectual disabilities. She has helped raise tens of thousands of dollars for Special Olympics and helps make CDCR the biggest law enforcement contributor to Special Olympics in Northern California. Her work not only helps the Special Olympics, but enhances our department's image. The Special Olympics was so impressed with her work that it invited her to present a program on working with correctional systems at an international Special Olympics conference in 2014. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Undersecretary Pogue. Dr. Diana Tosh, Undersecretary for Healthcare Services, will present the next set of awards.
Good morning, everyone. The unit citation is for great courage displayed by a departmental unit in the course of conducting an operation in the face of immediate life-threatening circumstances. Our first unit citation honorees are from Salinas Valley State Prison. Correctional officers Danny Delgidio, Brenda Sanchez, Daryl Schlitz, Tad Whitman, and Correctional Sergeant Daryl L. Williams, please come forward and receive your awards. Officers Servando Ceballos, Jason Sanudo, and Carlos Vega also were awarded the unit citations, but were not able to attend. In May 2015, black smoke was seen coming from a cell. As this team responded, flames were seen too. Using a fire hose and fire extinguishers, the flames were put out, but thick black smoke continued to come from the sides of the door and through the food port, making it hard to see the inmate. The team quickly made the decision to execute an emergency cell entrance to save the inmate's life. Risking their own safety, they removed the inmate, who was transported to an outside hospital for treatment of smoke inhalation. Thanks to their bravery and quick thinking, a life was saved. Congratulations. Our next unit citation honorees are from California State Prison, Sacramento. They are Correctional Officers Tyrone Johnson and Brianna Ortiz, Correctional Lieutenant Jeremy Prentice, Correctional Sergeants David Gonzalez, Stephen Byers, and Licensed Clinical Social Worker Catherine Manis. Please come forward to receive your awards. Also receiving unit citations are registered nurse Michelle Stein and officers Jason Murillo, Rolf Dixon, and Pateo Rashev, but they were unable to be here today. In February 2015, this team successfully and safely extracted an armed inmate from a cell. Some team members and the inmate suffered minor injuries in an incident that had the potential for major injuries. The incident started as the inmate refused to leave for admission to a crisis bed. The inmate refused to exit despite verbal attempts to persuade him and cooling off periods. The inmate secured a bed sheet to a light fixture so staff could not see what he was doing. The controlled application of chemical agents failed. The extraction team then entered the cell, upon which the inmate leaped from behind the sheet and attempted to reach around the officer's shields and stab them with an inmate-manufactured weapon. Officers forced the inmate to drop the weapon and subdued him. We praise the officers for their high degree and coordination of bravery. Congratulations. Our next unit citation honorees are from California Institution for Women. As I call your name, please come forward. Correctional Officers Lionel Garcia, Brandon Merkelbach, and Vincent Moraga, and Correctional Sergeant Mark Garcia. In November 2015, members of this team saw a large quantity of smoke pouring from the edges of a cell door. The two inmates inside did not respond to verbal requests. A decision was made quickly to enter the cell, but the inmates had jammed the door with clothing. A fire extinguisher was deployed through the food port, putting out the fire. The door was forced open and the two inmates rescued. By this time, smoke had filled the unit and members of the team, despite suffering from the smoke, helped evacuate the unit. The two inmates also suffered from smoke inhalation, but recovered thanks to the teamwork and bravery of this team. Our next unit citation honorees are from Kern Valley State Prison. As I call your name, please come forward. Correctional Officers Robert Perez, Ricky Charles, and registered nurse Claire Garavillo. Also receiving unit citations are officers Henry Arvillo Jr., Eric Dixon, Ernest Parker, Michael Renz, Daniel Vasquez, and Sergeant William Sullivan, who are unable to be here today. In September 2015, an inmate was discovered unresponsive in his cell. Members of this team responded to find the inmate wasn't breathing. A drug overdose was suspected. Team members began conducting CPR and relays as the inmate was removed from the cell to the day room floor and then to a gurney. The inmate began shallow breathing and was prepared for transport to a hospital. Other team members discovered a spoon and suspected heroin in his cell. This information was relayed to the medical responders and the treatment of the inmate was adjusted accordingly. Thanks to this team's quick work and coordination, a life was likely saved. Our next unit citation honorees are from California State Prison, Sacramento. As I call your name, please come forward. Correctional Officers Christopher Kazi, Seth Iganek, Jeff Leach, Robert Mott, Brianna Ortiz, Matthew Troth, and Paul Betancourt. Officer Dylan Brown is not here with us today. In June 2015, correctional officers were escorting two inmates to a prison treatment center when one of the inmates freed one of his hands. Using an inmate-manufactured weapon, he attacked one of the officers. The other inmate took advantage and began kicking officers. Members of this team quickly subdued the armed inmate, removing the weapon from his control. Other members stepped in to stop the kicking attack. The wounded officer was quickly removed from danger and given prompt medical attention. Thanks to their fast action and bravery, members of this team saved a correctional officer from severe injury or possibly death. Bronze Stars. The Bronze Star Medal is the department's award for saving a life without placing oneself in peril. The employee shall have used proper training and tactics in a professional manner to save or clearly contribute to saving the life of another person. Our first Bronze Stars are awarded to correctional officers Juan Aguirre and Travon Roger from the Richard J. Donovan Correctional Facility. Please come forward. In January 2015, Officer Rogers was picking up evening meal trays when he saw an inmate slumped over near his toilet cell. Officers Rogers and Aguirre removed the unresponsive inmate from the cell and placed him flat on the floor. The inmate was not breathing. Officer Aguirre began giving rescue breath and Officer Rogers began chest compressions. The inmate began breathing just before medical responders arrived and he recovered. Thanks to the fast action and correct medical response, Officers Rogers and Aguirre saved a life. Our next Bronze Star is awarded to Correctional Officer Gary Gomez from Ironwood State Prison. Please come forward. In January 2015, while off duty and driving, Officer Gomez saw a motorcycle rider fly over his handlebars of his bike, and then the bike ran over him. Officer Gomez parked his vehicle so no other vehicles could run over the victim in the roadway. The victim was not breathing and had no pulse. Officer Gomez began CPR. After a fourth cycle of CPR, the victim began to breathe, but in less than a minute quit breathing again. Officer Gomez continued CPR until the victim began breathing once more. He recovered, and thanks to the quick actions of Officer Gomez, lived to ride again. Our next Bronze Stars are awarded to correctional officers Raymond Dominguez and Joshua Priester of Folsom State Prison. Please come forward. In April 2015, the two officers were traveling in El Dorado County and came upon a man who had driven his electric scooter into the curb, sustaining serious injuries. They stopped and rendered first aid to the victim, risking their own safety on the heavily traveled roadway. Officer Dominguez stabilized and treated the man's head injury, while Officer Priester stopped a heavily bleeding arm wound by applying pressure until medical responders arrived. Officer Dominguez and Priester's swift and professional actions possibly saved the life of the victim. Our next Bronze Stars are awarded to Correctional Officer Derek Kelly of Pelican Bay State Prison and retired Correctional Lieutenant Wayne Anthony. Officer Kelly, please come forward. In April 2015, Officer Kelly's father, a retired Correctional Lieutenant, suffered a major heart attack at his home while preparing food for Officer Kelly's birthday. After Officer Kelly found his father on the kitchen floor, he was not breathing. Officer Kelly immediately began CPR. Another family member ran next door and alerted Lieutenant Anthony, who immediately responded. Officer Kelly and Lieutenant Anthony traded off doing CPR until medical responders arrived. Thanks to their quick and professional actions, the life of Officer Kelly's father was saved. Our next Bronze Star is awarded to Corrections Food Manager 1, Joseph Jasso of Chuckawalla Valley State Prison. Please come forward. In April 2015, Mr. Jasso came upon the scene of a head-on collision while commuting to work. In an overturned car, he found the driver pinned in the wreckage. Fearing the vehicle would catch fire, Mr. Jasso used a crowbar to deflate the airbag. He crawled into the wreckage and released the steering wheel so he and another person who stopped could pull the driver to safety. Mr. Jasso showed bravery and concern for a fellow human being in distress. Congratulations. Our next Bronze Star is awarded to Correctional Sergeant Stan Tuck of Avenal State Prison. Please come forward. In September 2015, a trip to the grocery store for Sergeant Tuck turned into a call for him to use his CPR skills and save a life. While driving, he saw an elderly woman prone on the sidewalk. He parked and checked the woman's vital signs. She stopped breathing and Sergeant Tuck began CPR. The woman finally took a deep breath and began moaning. Sergeant Tuck monitored her until medical responders arrived. Sergeant Tuck was modest about his life-saving efforts. He said, "I did not save that lady's life. The Avenal State Prison CPR instructors saved her life." Our next Bronze Star is awarded to Correctional Officer Carla Joseph of the California Healthcare Facility. Please come forward. In July 2015, Officer Joseph was on her way to work when she spotted a car on its roof off to the side of the road. A man and his dog were crawling out of the wreckage. She pulled over, called 911, and tended to the victim. The driver of the vehicle was in shock and was trying to crawl into the car to gather some personal items. Officer Joseph helped him away from the vehicle, which had started leaking gas and oil. She stayed with him and to make sure the victim did not go into severe shock until emergency responders arrived. Undersecretary Pogue will complete the awarding of the Bronze Stars.
Our next Bronze Star is awarded to Karen Elliott, Correctional Case Records Administrator. Ms. Elliott is unable to attend here today due to a family illness. In September of 2015, while walking her dog, she heard screams for help. She found a woman in a carport whose arm was pinned between a vehicle and a support beam. The arm was bleeding heavily. Ms. Elliott jumped in the car and backed it up, freeing the victim's arm. Ms. Elliott applied pressure to the wound and supported the arm until a passerby who had EMT experience applied a tourniquet. Ms. Elliott continued to provide emotional support for the victim until medical responders arrived. Congratulations. Our next Bronze Star is awarded to Geraldo Garcia, pharmacy technician at the Central California Women's Facility. Please come forward. In December 2015, a certified nursing assistant was conducting a routine psychiatric video conference with an inmate who suddenly became disruptive. The inmate threw a computer monitor on the floor and moved towards the nursing assistant, who activated her personal alarm. Mr. Garcia, who was in the next room, heard the noise and came to her rescue by subduing the inmate until custody staff arrived. It was later found that the certified nursing assistant's personal alarm had failed, and therefore Mr. Garcia saved the victim from a possible serious injury. Congratulations. Our next bronze stars are awarded to correctional officers Sean Dawson and Victor Ruiz of Chuckawalla Valley State Prison. Please come forward. In December 2015, Officers Dawson and Ruiz were driving together to work when they witnessed a traffic accident. A large SUV struck the center median and then flipped over two times, landing on its wheels. Officer Dawson saw that a nine-year-old child, had been ejected and was lying on the shoulder. He tended to the child. Officer Ruiz checked on the other two children, ages 4 and 14, who were still in the vehicle. He also checked on the danger of the vehicle catching on fire. Officer Ruiz, who is fluent in Spanish, calmed the mother and father, who were not fluent in English. After medical responders arrived, Officer Ruiz acted as a translator between the family and the EMTs. Thank you and congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Correctional Sergeant Eric Baker of California State Prison, Sacramento. Please come forward. In January 2015, Sergeant Baker was headed home from work when he came upon a traffic accident. A pickup truck was upside down in the roadway. As Sergeant Baker approached the vehicle, he saw large amounts of fuel pouring from the fuel tank. He then saw a man was trapped inside the pickup truck. The man was conscious and said he was not seriously injured, but could not get out of the vehicle. Sergeant Baker reached into the vehicle and pulled the man to safety. Sergeant Baker later learned the victim was a CDCR correctional officer from Folsom State Prison, who has since recovered from the accident. Thank you and congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Special Agent Roy Dickinson of the Office of Correctional Safety Fugitive Apprehension Team in Fresno. Please come forward. Agent Dickinson was traveling on Highway 180 when he came upon a one-car accident. The car was sitting in the roadway, severely damaged and smoking. Agent Dickinson positioned his vehicle with emergency lights on to keep the car from getting hit again. He checked inside and found the driver had major injuries and was complaining of neck and chest pain. Using his mass casualty first aid kit, Agent Dickinson stabilized the victim's neck with a collar brace and dressed bleeding wounds. At risk of his own safety, he stayed in the car with the victim until medical responders arrived. Thank you and congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Correctional Officer Marco Arena of the California Institute for Women. Please come forward. In November 2015, while conducting a random security check, Officer Arena saw a female inmate in her cell bleeding profusely from her forearms. The inmate was cutting herself with a razor and had refused to put it down. She then appeared to swallow the razor. After responding staff arrived, Officer Arena wrapped the bleeding arm with a towel and applied pressure. He instructed the inmate to elevate the arm in an effort to slow the bleeding. The inmate's wound required 35 sutures, but thanks to the quick professional actions of Officer Arena, she survived. Thank you. Congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Correctional Sergeant Fernando Herrera of the Office of Training and Personal Development. Sergeant Herrera is unfortunately unable to be here today. In August 2015, Sergeant Herrera was off duty at a local movie theater when one of the moviegoers became confused and dizzy. Sergeant Herrera assisted the man from the movie. He recognized the man was in distress and called for EMTs. The man's condition rapidly deteriorated in the waiting room and Sergeant Herrera summoned medical help. Due to the sergeant's recognizing the symptoms of a stroke and his fast action in the ER, the man sustained no permanent damage. Congratulations and thank you. Our next bronze star is awarded to Correctional Officer Christian Logan of Kern Valley State Prison. Please come forward. In April 2015, Officer Logan was in his backyard when he heard a woman scream for help. He responded and found a woman standing in a nearby driveway holding a baby. The woman said the baby had fallen into a pool. The baby had turned blue and was not breathing. He told the woman to put the baby in the grass and he began CPR. After about 2 minutes of CPR, the baby spit out water and started crying. Officer Logan continued to monitor the baby and comfort the mother and her four-year-old daughter until responders arrived. Officer Logan's fast professional actions saved a young life. Thank you. Congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Derek Johnson, Associate Construction Analyst. Please come forward. In July 2015, Mr. Johnson saw a colleague collapse while at work and noticed he was not breathing. Mr. Johnson immediately began giving CPR. Other members of the office assisted until medical responders arrived. At ER, the doctor stated that the victim was, quote, probably the luckiest guy in Sacramento today, end quote, because of the actions of Mr. Johnson and others. The doctor said if it weren't for the fast professional actions by Mr. Johnson and others, the victim would have died. Thank you and congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Correctional Officer Doug Sykes of the California Correctional Center. Please come forward. In June 2015, Officer Sykes was transporting an inmate when an oncoming delivery truck rear-ended a pickup truck, sending the pickup into the path of Officer Sykes' van. Officer Sykes avoided the hitting the pickup by taking evasive action. After confirming his partner and the inmate were not injured, Officer Sykes checked on the crash victims. He rendered aid to two crash victims who suffered major injuries. He stabilized the neck of one victim until medical responders arrived. Officer Sykes' fast, professional actions saved his partner and inmate from injury and saved two of the crash victims from further injury. Thank you and congratulations. Our next bronze star is awarded to Correctional Officer Stacy Emerson of High Desert State Prison. Please come forward. July 2015, while on her way to work, Officer Emerson pulled up to the scene of a motorcycle accident where the victim was lying in the fast lane of the highway. Officer Emerson stopped her car and rushed to his aid. The victim, who unknown to Officer Emerson, was a fellow correctional officer, was unresponsive and not breathing. She immediately started CPR while still in the fast lane of the highway and was able to revive him. The victim was transported to the hospital where he later died. The victim's wife was grateful to Officer Emerson, saying, "She gave me a chance to say goodbye to my husband." Thank you and congratulations. Our next bronze stars are awarded to Correctional Lieutenant Robert Gamberg, Sr. of California Correctional Center, Correctional Officer David Church of High Desert State Prison, and Supervising Register Nursery Craig Phillips of High Desert State Prison. Please come forward. When Lieutenant Gamberg came up on the scene of a two-car accident in July 2015, he saw a High Desert State Prison employee was already hard at work helping the victims. Officer Church had pulled both victims from their vehicle and was rendering assistance. While Officer Church worked on one victim, Lieutenant Gamberg calmed the other. At this time, another High Desert employee rolled onto the scene. Supervising Registered Nurse Craig Phillips jumped in and provided medical treatment to both victims as Officer Church and Lieutenant Gamberg directed traffic until relieved by CHP and CAL FIRE. Thank you, congratulations. Undersecretary Tosh will now award the Silver Stars.
The Silver Star is the department's third highest award for acts of bravery under extraordinary or unusual circumstances. The employee shall display courage in the face of potential peril while saving or attempting to save the life of another person, or distinguish him or herself by performing in a stressful situations with exceptional tactics or judgment. The first Silver Star is awarded to parole agent John Edelman. Please come forward. In January 2015, Agent Edelman and Sacramento Police K-9 officer went to a residence in search of a parolee at large. The woman they encountered confirmed the parolee was in the apartment. The parolee resisted arrest and the K-9 dog was unleashed. The parolee gave up after he was severely bitten by the dog. Agent Edelman applied a tourniquet as the parolee passed out from loss of blood. Agent Edelman continued to treat the parolee until medical responders arrived. His quick professional actions possibly saved a life. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Stars are awarded to three parole agents with the California Parole Apprehension Team, or CPAT. Kenneth Thomas, Sean Torfey, and Ben Zomera. Agent Sean Torfey is unable to be here today. In March 2015, a fugitive who was wanted for sexually assaulting a juvenile was confronted by members of the San Diego Marshals Fugitive Task Force, which included CPAT members. The fugitive attempted to flee in a vehicle. Members of the Fugitive Task Force fired their weapons at the vehicle, halting the attempted escape. Agents Thomas, Torfey, and Zomera saw that the fugitive was bleeding profusely from his wounds. Working as a team, they applied chest seals, a tourniquet, blood-clotting agents, and other medical aid to stop the bleeding. The fugitive underwent 4 hours of surgery at the hospitals. Doctors said the team's action saved the fugitive's lives. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Stars are awarded to Correctional Lieutenants John Mendebor and Michael Tunticket of Avenal State Prison. Please come forward. In April 2015, lieutenants, while on their way home, helped save a young woman after her car careened about 100 yards down a steep embankment and overturned, and she was trapped. The two lieutenants were flagged down by a driver who witnessed the accident. As the engine began to smoke, the lieutenants used a rock to break a window and pull the driver from the wreck. Thanks to their brave and quick actions, the driver escaped serious injury or possibly death. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Star is awarded to Correctional Officer Rafael Diaz of Correctional Training Facility. Please come forward. In September 2015, an armed robber stole drugs and fled a pharmacy in Salinas. Officer Diaz, who was nearby, and another citizen went in pursuit. The robber turned and fired a shot that missed. Officer Diaz and the citizen rushed the robber, disarmed him, and held him until law enforcement officers arrived. Officer Diaz's brave actions were in the best traditions of CDCR's law enforcement service. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Stars are awarded to Correctional Officers Peter Vanderford and Mario Gutierrez of Prado Conservation Camp Number 28. Please come forward. In May 2015, the officers were waiting for a tow truck outside their state vehicle after it became disabled on Interstate 15. A motorcycle rider lost control of his bike nearby and ended up on the busy road with severe injuries. The two officers entered the busy highway to help the rider. They stabilized his injuries and kept him from going into shock. With the help of the truck driver, they removed the wrecked motorcycle from the road and blocked off a section to keep vehicles from hitting them or the victim. Thanks in part to the bravery and swift actions of Officers Vanderford and Gutierrez, the victim survived. The next Silver Star is awarded to Parole Administrator Quincy Thacker. In December 2015, Administrator Thacker was stopped in traffic. He witnessed another vehicle changing lanes strike a moving motorcycle, sending the rider through the rear window of another vehicle. Administrator Thacker got out of his car and rendered medical aid to the seriously injured victim. He was able to give life-saving aid to the victim on a busy roadway until first responders arrived. Thanks in part to his bravery and quick actions, the victim survived. The The next Silver Star is awarded to Parole Agent 1, Edward Sanchez. Please come forward. In January 2015, Agent Sanchez was returning to his office when he spotted a victim of a shooting sitting on the ground. Agent Sanchez determined the shooter was still at large and possibly in the area. Despite the danger, Agent Sanchez gave life-saving aid to the victim who had been shot twice in the rib area. He stabilized the victim until medical help arrived. His bravery and swift actions kept that person alive. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Stars are awarded to Youth Authority Correctional Officer Miguel Lopez and Youth Authority Lieutenant Vincent Cias, both of Ventura Youth Correctional Facility. Please come forward. In December 2015, this pair were on their way to work in heavy traffic when a vehicle sped by them. The driver of the vehicle lost control of the vehicle, hit a guardrail, and the vehicle rolled several times, coming to rest in the roadway. Officer Lopez used his vehicle to block the lane to keep traffic from hitting the overturned vehicle. The driver was trapped, but otherwise not severely injured. Lieutenant Cias broke the windshield and both men pulled the driver to safety. They then gave the driver basic first aid until emergency services arrived. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Star is awarded to Correctional Officer Steve M. Mello of North Kern State Prison. Please come forward. In December 2015, Officer Mello was driving in a CDCR transportation vehicle, which was not carrying inmates. He saw a CHP vehicle maneuver to stop a fleeing vehicle. The driver of the fleeing vehicle attempted to run, and the CHP officer stopped and restrained him. Officer Mello, noting the CHP officer did not need help, saw another occupant in the vehicle. To keep him from interfering with the CHP officer, Officer Mello ordered the passenger to keep his hands in view and stay in the vehicle. Without knowing if the other car occupant was armed, Officer Mello put himself at risk for fellow law enforcement officer and kept a dangerous incident from escalating. The next Silver Stars are awarded to three officers at California State Prison Sacramento. Correctional Sergeant Daryl Negrin, Correctional Officers Ronnie Willer and Ted Zier. Sergeant Negrin is unable to be here. Officers Wheeler and Zier, please come forward. In June 2015, two inmates with inmate-manufactured weapons attacked a third inmate. Officer Wheeler quickly spotted the attack and ordered the yard down as he alerted other officers. The armed inmates refused orders to stop. Observation Officer Zur, judging the victim to be in danger of death, fired one round from his rifle, striking one of the attacking inmates in the shoulder. Showing excellence, command, and presence, Sergeant Negrin was able to get the second inmate to stop the attack and drop his weapon. The fast, professional actions of these officers likely saved an inmate's life. The next Silver Stars are awarded to Correctional Officers Aaron Brannon and Christopher Causey of California State Prison Sacramento. Please come forward. In July 2015, Officers Brannon and Causey were escorting inmates when one of the inmates attacked another with an inmate-manufactured weapon. Officer Brannon pulled the armed inmate from his victim. Officer Causey grabbed the inmate by the wrist of the hand holding the weapon and ordered him to get down. But the inmate continued to struggle. Both officers used physical force and finally succeeded in getting the inmate to the floor. Still struggling, the inmate eventually released his weapon, but not before cutting both officers. Officers Kazi and Brandon recovered from their wounds. Their bravery and professional actions possibly saved a life. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Stars are awarded to three correctional officers at Wasco State Prison and Reception Center. The honorees are correctional officers Chad Look, Luis De La Torre, and Tyson Manning. Officer De La Torre and Manning cannot be here today. Officer Look, please come forward. In August 2015, these officers came across a collision and rollover accident that left four people trapped in an SUV. Despite the strong odor of gasoline and imminent danger of fire, the three officers worked as a team to remove the victims to safety. Working against time because of the leak, they removed two adults and two children, a five-year-old and a three-year-old. The officers displayed bravery and teamwork in rescuing four people from a dangerous situation. Thank you and congratulations. The next Silver Star is awarded to Correctional Officer Daniel Rodriguez of San Quentin State Prison. Please come forward. In January 2015, Correctional Officer Cadet Daniel Rodriguez was a cadet at Richard A. McGee Correctional Training Center. His rookie status did not stop him from catching a robbery subject while off duty. Officer Rodriguez saw the suspect fleeing with another man in pursuit. The situation looked suspicious. He stopped the man and asked why he was running. The suspect responded by trying to stab Officer Rodriguez in the eye with a screwdriver. The officer Rodriguez said, "The training I got kicked in and I was able to control him." The suspect did succeed in stabbing Officer Rodriguez in the chin, causing a minor wound, but that did not stop Officer Rodriguez from detaining the suspect until other law enforcement officers arrived. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you, Undersecretary Tosh. Our final awards will be made by Kathleen Allison, Director of the Division of Adult Institutions.
Well, good morning, everybody. It is certainly my privilege and honor to be here today to honor all of you for your awards. So I welcome the friends and the family that are here to support you as well. The Gold Star is the department's second highest award for heroic deeds under extraordinary circumstances. The employee shall display courage in the face of immediate peril in acting to save the life of another person. Our Gold Star this year is awarded to Correctional Officer Jesus Blandon from the California Healthcare Facility. Please come forward. In November 2015, an inmate attacked a correctional officer with his fist after being released from a cell. The initial attack knocked the correctional officer unconscious. The inmate continued his attack, kicking the officer as well, as he shouted, I'm gonna kill you. Officer Blandon was nearby and ran to the unconscious officer's aid. Using his baton, Officer Blandon forced the inmate away and pulled the unconscious officer to safety. Officer Blandon's brave and prompt actions possibly saved a life of a fellow staff member. Thank you and congratulations. Our next awards are the Medal of Valor is the department's highest award. It is an award to employees who distinguish themselves by conspicuous bravery or heroism above and beyond normal demands of correctional service. Our first Medal of Valor award to Correctional Officer Mike R. Johnson from Salinas Valley State Prison. Please come forward. In February 2015, Officer Johnson was on his way home when he came across a two-car accident with one vehicle on fire. Officer Johnson and a Marin Police Department officer rescued a woman from the burning vehicle, carrying her to safety just before the vehicle became engulfed in flames. Officer Johnson also moved to safety another victim who was on the ground near the burning vehicle. Both victims survived and are recovering. Officer Johnson sustained burns but did not seek medical attention. In a Facebook post, the Marin County Police Department stated, "Officer Johnson really did an outstanding job. Mike Johnson, your actions were commendable and did not go unnoticed." The victim's family was left financially strapped due to the health care bills. Officer Johnson is now helping the victim raise money for the health care. Thank you and congratulations. Our next Medal of Valor award to Correctional Officer Jamie Appleberry of California State Prison, Sacramento. Please come forward. In September 2015, while off duty, Officer Appleberry returned to her apartment early in the morning with a friend. After pulling into the parking lot, the friend was in the process of getting out of the passenger side when Officer Appleberry saw an armed man with a pistol walking towards her. She jumped back into the vehicle and tried to lock the doors. The armed man opened the passenger door and put a gun to her friend's head. He also pointed the gun to Officer Appleberry. The gunman grabbed the friend's hair with his free hand and was pulling her out of the vehicle. Fearing for her safety, Officer Appleberry jumped out of the car, ran around, and fought with the gunman for control of the weapon. The gunman tried to point the pistol at Officer Appleberry's face. She forced the pistol up into the air as the gunman fired two shots. At this point, the friend was able to help Officer Appleberry in the fight. Officer Appleberry gained control of the gun, and she and her friend ran, but the assailant followed. Officer Appleberry pointed the gun at the assailant and pulled the trigger. The gun did not fire, but her act still caused the assailant to run. Officer Appleberry credited her CDCR training for helping her survival. She said, "I thank God I received training in self-defense." The courage of Officer Appleberry, who suffered a non-serious head laceration in the fight, saved her and her roommate from serious injury or death. Congratulations.
Congratulations to all of our award recipients. This concludes our ceremony. CDCR thanks all of you for coming. This church requires the use of this room at 1:30. And so we have a little time, but we respectfully ask that you clear the room by that time. Thank you all.